testing. Can y'all hear me out there? All right. Awesome. Seeing traffic coming in the door slow a little bit, so we're gonna get started. Feels like it's... All right, there we go. Okay, welcome everyone. My name is Lindsay Walters. I am the school counselor at Longfellow High School. And it's been my pleasure to work with our graduates here. So I wanna say good evening. Families, friends, and loved ones, thank you for joining us for our very favorite day of the year. Honestly, this is the best day of the year. The day that we celebrate the hard work and accomplishments of this incredible group of young women. Thank you, families, for trusting us with your loved ones and for teaming with us on this journey. Let us begin with this year's protocol. También el protocolo está en español en el programa. Welcome, graduates of the class of 2022, parents, friends, guests, school staff, and officials. Today we will honor students who have met the qualifications for graduation from a Minneapolis public high school. Because of the significance of this event and its importance in the lives of our graduates, we ask that all present respect the following guidelines. Please turn off all cell phones and any other electronic devices. Please hold your applause and cheers so each family may hear their graduate's name announced. We'll have a group applause for all graduates at the completion of the ceremony. If you want to take pictures during the ceremony, you must do so from your seat. No flash photography allowed. Processional videographers are recording and live streaming the graduation ceremony. The video of the graduation will be available on demand for viewing and download via the MPS website and replayed on cable TV channel 15 throughout the summer. We ask that everyone remain in their seats throughout the ceremony. The fire code prohibits anyone from being in the aisles. There is ample seating available for everyone. At the end of the program, we will have a recessional when the graduates will march out of the auditorium. We ask that you remain in your seats until all the graduates have marched out of the auditorium. We ask that you be respectful throughout the ceremony so that our graduates receive the appropriate recognition for their achievement. Please do not talk during the ceremony. Thank you for your dignified support and cooperation. And I always also like to acknowledge that this is a family occasion and we have little ones in our audience and we welcome them here. So we leave that to your discretion, but want you to know that this life is, there's life in this room and there are little lives in this room. And we know little lives sometimes make noise, and that's okay. So thank you again for being here. Next, I also want to read our land acknowledgement. We begin by acknowledging that we meet on the traditional, ancestral, and contemporary lands of Indigenous people, America's first people. We honor and recognize the Anishinaabe, Dakota, and additional tribal nations as the past, present, and future caretakers of this land. By offering this land acknowledgement, we affirm tribal sovereignty and will work to uphold the tribal history, culture, and contributions that have been suppressed in telling the story of America. Comenzamos reconociendo que nos encontramos en las tierras tradicionales, ancestrales y contemporáneas de los pueblos indígenas, los primeros pobladores de América. Honramos y reconocemos a los Anishinaabe, Dakota y otras naciones tribales como cuidadores pasados, presentes y futuros de esta tierra. Al ofrecer este reconocimiento de tierras, afirmamos la soberanía tribal y trabajaremos para defender la historia, la cultura y las contribuciones tribales que se han suprimido al contar la historia de los Estados Unidos. And next, we're ready to begin our processional. Please stand for our graduates. Next, I'd like to invite our principal up, Dr. Udapa.
Thank you. Good evening. Longfellow graduates, families, and staff, those of us who have had the pleasure of teaching and serving tonight's graduates are honored to be here today at their commencement ceremony. We are very proud of all our students and what they have accomplished. I'm honored to welcome all parents, families, school board directors, Director Kimberly Caprini, Director Ira Jordan, Superintendent Graff, Associate Superintendent Dr. Harris Berry, staff, and students. The graduating class of 2022 has truly been an exceptional group. We had an incredible journey together. We thought moving forward together after pandemic was going to be a routine school year. Well, we had COVID coordinator, that's me, posters all around the building about COVID protocol. We all knew how to handle the invisible virus, like washing our hands, keeping distance, and mask up. Most of us got vaccinated and ready to start the year. We thought nothing can stop us from learning. To our surprise, it was easy to plan on the paper and harder to adjust to the daily routines. We learned a lot from each other, both as a staff and as student, on how to do school. We leaned on each other to be physically and emotionally present each day. Physically, it was hard to adjust the routines of being at school every day. Emotionally, it was even harder as we still face the effects of pandemic. We still must test, isolate, and quarantine. Thus, it became constant distraction for learning this year. Despite all the struggles you faced, you showed resilience and courage to move forward. All of you showed grace and hope that brought joy to our everyday routine by celebrating different cultural events in the gym. We've held our first annual social justice summit led by our Dare to Be Real students. The speakers and presenters were dynamic, and all of us learned a lot about race, relationship, and social justice. And when our staff and students felt emotional stress due to various events that took place locally or nationally, they played volleyball together to regroup. Thank you, Longfellow family, for bringing us back together to do our daily routines of school. I would like to say to our students, I see you, I hear you, I am proud of you, and how amazing you are. Most of you have survived many life-altering events in your personal life, yet you approached your teachers and said you want to graduate. Let's give them a hand, please. That's what they said. All of our staff stepped up and planned to support our graduating students. Currently, I want to give a big shout out to our support staff and Check-In Connect coach, Ms. Malone Diang. They work tirelessly to create a climate so that students can thrive by providing tutoring one-on-one, food, housing needs, by being a mentor and a caregiver. I would also like to give a big shout out to all our teaching staff for making sure our students are welcomed, heard, and personalized the learning for them to succeed. Once again, let's give a round of applause for all our staff and students who went above and beyond. To meet the students' needs. Students, we are very proud of you. You have worked hard and achieved your goals to graduate. Several of you are planning to pursue your education at various institutions. Congratulations to all who won the scholarships. I have admired your willingness to do things for others and have taken leadership role at Longfellow. I want to send a special thanks to my associate superintendent, Dr. Harris Perry, for giving me the strength and support I needed to lead the building during this unusual year. Let's give applause to Dr. Harris Perry. I would also like to thank my staff for being there for me, as well as supporting our students. We would not be able to move forward without our community's support. Thank you, Dr. Philip and Vocal Essence, for partnering with us, and Saliana Uldu. Did I say it right?
Soliana.
Thank you for correcting me. For singing to our graduates today. She's a South High graduate. Holy Trinity Church for being with us throughout the pandemic and school year for our students and staff, our Early Learning Center staff. Those of you who are here, I want you to stand up. Without them, our babies, our moms could not graduate without all of you supporting the babies. Let's give them a round of applause, please. And MVNA nurses and school-based clinic. And thank you, Dorsey Whitney, Project Success, Family Partnership, and Achieve Twin Cities for continued support. It takes a family, a village, they say, to raise a family. That's what all these people are to us. They all joined us together to make sure you are supported. As you move forward, believe in yourself and keep your passions moving forward. And congratulations to all of you, class of 2022.
All right, next we are going to have our student speakers. So I'd like to welcome up Siantre Felton and Jamie Williams.
Guys, I'm Siantre. A lot of y'all know me as Shay. Before I read what I wrote, though, I just want y'all to give a shout out to my girls because we really worked hard these last 2 weeks, like for real. No sleep, nothing. Okay. All right. This is just something I wrote real quick for the staff and stuff. Hello, Longfellow staff and graduates. As I stand here today, I want to start off by giving the biggest shout out to the principal of Longfellow High School, Dr. Udipa. I never would have been able to stand here today without her. So wherever you are, thank you so much. I remember years ago when I met Dr. Udipa, I never in a million years would have thought that we would have ended up this close. Through all her sternness and endless motivation, I made it. I remember in the hallways every day she would tell me that I needed to graduate and that she wanted to be able to retire, like to know that she was good, done with me in a good way though. Secondly, I want to give my second biggest shout out to Malone Day Young. Malone is like my rock, my mentor, and my favorite everything all in one, seriously. It took me forever to finish high school, and she is one of my biggest motivators of all times. Last but not least, I want to thank Miss Geneva, Miss Lanice, Miss Vicky, and Lisa for helping me finish this journey. I want to say that I did this for me and my two children, but honestly, it would have been done if it was for them and myself. I did not do this for my kids, and I didn't do this for myself. I did this for their father. Hold on, y'all. Oh, y'all, I'm so sorry. I'm sorry, y'all. I'm not sad. I don't know why I'm crying. His biggest goal for me was for me to be an RN. Malik wanted me to finish school first to fulfill this goal, and I did it, and I couldn't be more proud of me and all of us here today. Even though he's no longer here with us, I'm pretty sure he's close enough to my heart because I couldn't have done this without him. And congratulations to class of 2022, and I hope this brings your family and future nothing but greatness.
I'm Jamie. I just want to say that I'm proud of my fellow staff and students for putting up with this year. We have beat COVID and terrible twos. And I want to say that I appreciate the kindness and the support from our staff. Longfellow is like my home away from home. And our staff is very caring, involved, and invested in our futures. Most people don't enjoy their days in high school, but I've been thrilled to come to Longfellow every day that I have been there. And having come here to, I can't read that far, I have weird glasses. Having come here, I accomplished a goal that I did not think that I would have done without Longfellow, and I don't think I would have chosen to do something post-secondary without their help. So that's very nice of you guys. As a teen parent, there's a lot of stereotypes and presumptions that moms can't continue their education because they're with their kids all the time or that they can't work towards their own goals. And I feel like when I come to Longfellow, they see you as a person and an individual, and they encourage us to do our best to invest in our own future and ourselves. And I really appreciate the thought that an effort that goes into every individual, that goes into every individual that goes to school there. And I want to thank Lindsay and Lisa for always being on my butt to get back to school. And I want to say thank you to Dr. Udapa for convincing me to walk across the stage. And I want to say thank you to Geneva for always being there when I needed her. And to Vicky, because I love her. And Mr. Jones for being my number one cheerleader throughout and advisor throughout all these years. And I want to say congrats to all my graduates and any other students that are here. I want to encourage you to work on your goals and know that anything is achievable. Thanks for listening.
Let's give them another hand. That's right, great job. All right, and next we are going to have our first musical selection. Please welcome up Soljana Woldu.
Mountains, bring it to its feet. Ooh.
Beautiful. Okay, next up, we have our staff address. I'd like to welcome up our staff speaker this year. This is Mitch Jones.
That's it. Now I'm going to go sit down. Hello, and welcome everyone to this exciting night. Graduates, I have three special thank yous to share with you tonight. I want to thank you for your resilience, your growth, and for letting us spend time with the amazing collection of young women that you are. Now, I won't be able to get everyone's awesomeness into one speech, so see me afterwards if you want to hear about how great your individual child is. 16 graduates. That is quite a few for any years, but let's not forget, this is 2022. Graduates, there have been numerous alternative paths and choices you could have taken over the past few years. Most seemed tempting at the time, but it's because you made the hard choices that you did that you are sitting here right now in this auditorium. Sitting here in your fancy clothes, your fancy robes, and a room full of proud loved ones behind you. Not only did you complete all your schoolwork and pass your tests to earn this diploma, but you did it in the year 2022. Without a doubt, these last few years have been the hardest in my 15-year career. Hopefully, I'm not offending anyone by saying this, but online learning was pretty hard. So that brings me to my first of the three thank yous. I want to thank you for your resilience. You earned your diploma after going through the gauntlet of pain and boredom that sometimes was online learning. There was also quarantines and mask wearing. It was tough for everyone, but it was especially difficult for those who thrive on solid relationships and high engagement at school. Yet, here you are today. People often talk about hurdles or obstacles in people's lives. Well, the word hurdle never seemed to correctly summarize the challenges you faced on an almost daily occurrence. A hurdle is a little obstacle that you can jump over. You have conquered mountains. For the past few years, you woke up every day and conquered those giant obstacles. High school isn't easy. High school during a pandemic is harder. High school in a pandemic with a child at home? Whoa. Yet, here you are today. My second thank you is for letting us see you grow. While we do get paid for this job, nothing is like the reward of seeing the growth of you timid new moms into the powerhouse young women sitting before us. Jamie, seeing the tuned out young student turn into the leader that you have become has been amazing. There were times when I realized that we should just turn the mic over to you to lead some of our assemblies. I'm so proud of everything you have accomplished and the person you have become. Shay, few students seem as grown as you are today. Seeing you in your internship scrubs and hearing you talk has made it clear that you are ready and able to go out and conquer that thing called the real world. Apple, you are thoughtful and a deep person. You always kept me on my toes in history class, always had a question about the injustices that people experienced, and were always ready to look for the real story behind the textbook version. You're gonna go far with that critical eye. Maddie, you are quiet and resilient. Maddie just keeps plucking away at what she needs to accomplish, whether it's from the state of Georgia or from Prior Lake or while juggling three kids. Maddie got it done. Jennifer Roses, you did it. while being assistant manager and working full-time. You are the exact example of what these graduates have gone through. So congratulations. To the young graduates, Tanaya and Elijah. Graduating high school, check. Doing it with a kid, check. Doing it a year early, wow. Impressive hard work. And we can't wait to see what you accomplish at D3/college next year. Notori, you are a spark of energy and joy. Don't forget what you can accomplish when that energy is focused on something you want, like graduating. Angelica, Veronica, Ashley, Neilani, Betty, and Aaliyah, you all have full lives outside of school. But you never stop coming back. That shows your high level of stick-with-itness. It's a valuable trait to have. And tonight is your reward for this commitment. Sylvia and Veronica, it has been a pleasure watching you push yourselves to learn the material while also learning a new language. It is the definition of being resilient. Now, my last thank you. It is for bringing so much joy to Longfellow. There have been good times and there have been bad times. But thank you for sharing it all with us. You will never know just how much joy, laughter, and happiness you 16 young women have brought into our lives at Longfellow. You are amazing. I know all of us feel absolutely honored to have been a small bit part in the amazing stories you are all writing for yourself and your children. Thank you, and most importantly, congratulations.
I'm sitting back here clapping, slacking on my job. All right, next I'd like to invite Dr. Udapa up for the presentation of the class of 2022.
Director Caprini and Superintendent Graff, I certify that these seniors have met all the requirements for graduation as specified by Minneapolis Public Schools and the state of Minnesota.
Thank you, Principal Udapa. On behalf of Minneapolis Public Schools Board of Education, it is my sincere honor to accept the 2022 senior class of Longfellow High School. Principal Udapa, would you please complete the event?
Thank you, Director Caprini. I would like to ask Lindsay Walters, our counselor, to call the names of our graduating seniors.
Okay, graduates, you can stand. And you can go ahead and line up behind the stage. And if we have a building engineer available, is there anyone here that is able to open the curtain in the middle there? We're good. Never mind, we're good. Okay. All right, every year I am blown away by the quality and grit of our graduating group. And this year's group is truly something special to us, though. In this group, we have true leaders. We've been together through many seasons and had the privilege of really watching you grow up. There have been devastating losses. There have been unbelievable victories. Each one of these young women has been able to overcome and has risen above. All right, and I'm going to acknowledge that we have two students that were unable to join us today, but I still want to say their name and celebrate their accomplishment. So to that end, the first student who could not be here is Madeline Alvarez. All right, and diplomas. First one of the evening is going to Lakota Apple. Veronica Chamba Paulasine. Aaliyah Dancy. Delijah Edwards Brown. Sianche Felton. Leilani Hatcher. And Veronica Montelongo. Who unfortunately couldn't join us tonight, but we wish to congratulate her and her family. Next we have Betty Ramirez Sanchez. And my apologies, I just jumped out of order. Next, we have Natori Green. All right. Next, we have Jennifer Rosas. Way to go. Oh, yep, you're good. Next, we have Angelica Saldivar. Next, we have Tanaya Smith. All right, we have another who is unable to join us. That would be Ashley Toscano-Salas. Next, we have Sylvia Vicente Diaz. All right, and last but not least, we have Jamie Williams. All right, I want to take a moment to honor our youngest in the room. In one way or another, we are all here because of them. They've been the inspiration, the motivation, the future. The ones that we are all here to uphold and fight to protect. Let us take a moment to acknowledge and celebrate them, because they are seeing their mom walk across this stage tonight. They're seeing their mom can do this, and someday they will too. So little friends, if you are here, let us cheer for you. today we've got a seat for Jordan, Jaden, Jace, Dakota, Josias, Dalea, DeAndre, Tequila, Elijah, Micaiah, Kinari, Aviana, Kehlani, Sophia, Jasmine, Joshua, Jalen, Nayeli, Jaden, Kehlani, Lila, Yoseline, Isaiah, and JJ. And I want to give a special shout out to our little big kids that are graduating and moving on to kindergarten next year. That would be Jordan, Dakota, Kinari, and Isaiah. All right, and next we have our music selection. Again, let's please give a round of applause. This is Soljana Woldu. Thank you.
Bye.
Congratulations, oh my God. I'm so excited for all of you. All right, thank you very much. And I have one more student who is coming. She drives a long way. And this girl has stayed with us when she was moving out of state for a while. She has had long daily commutes and had to do it with three little ones that were tugging at her sleeves in tow. So she deserves this moment to walk across the stage. So last, we have Madeline Alvarez.
Seniors, please stand. Are you ready? Okay. At this time, please move your tassel from the right side of your cap to the left. Family members, friends, and staff, I present to you the 2022 graduating class of Longfellow High School. Congratulations, graduates. Let's give them another round of applause. Now, if you want to toss your hat, you can do so.
And cue the final music.